In this video, I'm going to show you how to record a journal entry when a company declares dividends. So we're going to look at two different scenarios. In the first scenario, the company declares a cash dividend and then immediately pays the dividend to the shareholders. In the second scenario, we'll also have a cash dividend, but the company won't immediately pay out the dividend. And yes, the accounting is different for each scenario. So let's go with this basic scenario first. So the company has declared a cash dividend. Let's say it's a $500 cash dividend. And so now we have to journalize that. Okay, so we're clearly going to be crediting cash for $500 because the company is paying out $500 of cash. We're assuming they're immediately paying out this dividend. So where are we going to debit? Well, we're going to debit the dividends account. We're going to debit dividends for $500, and then we're going to credit cash for $500. So that's our entry. So how does this affect the financial statements? Well, the cash account, when that goes down, that is going to reduce total assets. Now, the dividends account does not show up on the balance sheet, on the income statement. So you might wonder, how does that affect the financial statements? Well, remember, so the dividends account is a temporary account. So at the end of a period, it's going to get closed out to retained earnings. So when we do the period end closing, we're going to debit retained earnings for $500. And then we're going to credit the dividend account for $500. Okay, so we're going to close this out. This entry here is to record the declaration of the dividends and the payment of the dividends. Here, this is the closing entry at the end of the period. And why do I show you that? Because ultimately, this transaction is going to reduce equity. Stockholders' equity is going to go down, and it goes down when we do the closing ultimately. But this entry here from declaring dividends, the company is not only reducing its assets by paying out the cash, but it's also reducing its stockholders' equity. So even though dividends don't show up on a balance sheet or an income statement, they reduce retained earnings and therefore reduce stockholders' equity. So now let's look at the scenario where the company declares a cash dividend but then does not immediately pay it out. And this is more realistic. A lot of times company will say, look, we're gonna have a dividend this quarter, but they don't instantly go and pay out the dividend. So this is a little bit more realistic. So in this scenario, let's again say it's a $500 cash dividend. In this scenario, we're still going to debit the dividends account for $500. But now instead of crediting cash, what we're gonna credit is dividend payable. So we'll credit dividends payable for $500. Now, notice, if somebody were to ask you, what is the effect of this transaction? Well, ultimately, we know the dividends account at the end of the period is going to get closed out to retained earnings. So that's going to reduce stockholders' equity. And now, this payable account, this is a liability. So this is going to increase liability. So liabilities go up, equity goes down. Assets still equal total liabilities plus equity. Our fundamental accounting equation balances. Now, this account right here will throw some students off because people will see the dividend payable. This will be on the balance sheet. And people say, hey, wait a minute. I thought the dividends don't show up on the balance sheet. And they don't. This account here, the dividend account, does not show up on the balance sheet. It just affects retained earnings. This account here is different. The dividend payable is different from the dividend account. They're two separate accounts. And dividend payable is just saying, look, we declared a dividend and we owe people money. This is no different than like accounts payable, notes payable. It's just saying we have a liability that we have incurred. We have an obligation to sacrifice resources at some point in the future. Now, when that time comes and the company actually goes and pays the dividend, then you would say, okay, dividends payable, we're going to do debit for $500 because remember, liabilities go up with a credit, so they go down with a debit. Once we've paid this, we no longer have the liability, and then we're going to credit cash for $500. Then at the end of the period, we would have that same closing entry where we would close out where we'd say, okay, we better debit the retained earnings account, which remember, the retained earnings is an equity account, increases with a credit, therefore it goes down with the debit. So we would still have this entry where we debit retained earnings and credit dividends, which again, ultimately, by declaring dividends, what the company is doing is it's reducing its stockholders' equity.